Hi friends, Dr. Ryan here and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Dear friends, we were discussing on the greatest psychological discoveries and I have already uploaded three videos and which includes introduction and other discoveries, which also tells you that why we should give importance to the small things in our life or why we need to be really careful with the positive aspects and negative aspects of our life. Dear friends, today in this in the last part of psychological discoveries, I'll be discussing with you people who treat themselves with compassion, feel better about themselves and their bodies. I think as we go on, I think I can discuss better I feel. See, a 2014 study by Kelly et al. Found that women who treat themselves with more kindness and compassion are better able to cope with disappointments and setbacks in life. They were also less reactive to other people's judgments or criticism of their body shape and size. Maybe, dear friends, this study which gives us an indication that how we treat ourselves, do we really treat ourselves with a compassion, or do we really feel good and better of our own bodies? And how we really, in what eyes we see others' body shape or figure or anything. Dear friends, I think the sentence is very clear here. They were also less reactive to other people's judgments or criticism of their body shape and size. Dear friends, the question is very simple. Do I really like me? How I really define myself? No matter what I am, no matter what my body size is, no matter how I look, no matter what my shape of my body is, do I really love myself? Do I really take care of my own body in better way? Do I really work for my body? Do I really loves my body? That is very important. And these studies, which gives a clear indication that, see, who treat themselves with more kindness and compassion are better able to cope with disappointments and setbacks in life. So, dear friends, what happened? Many a time, if I don't have these things just now what I discussed with you, life takes us back. We are degraded, we are disappointed, and a lot of things. Even then, what happened? The small things create us more problems, more blocks. So, I think this here, it is very clear that people who treat themselves with compassion feel better about themselves and their bodies. The two sentences or two words are very important. Feel better about themselves and their bodies. Dear friends, we should also know that when I feel better about myself, when I really love myself, what I am and the way I am, I think that gives us a better meaning for our life. It doesn't mean that I have to come out from my negativeness. I have to come out. I have to really find my mental health or I have to understand my mental health. I'm not speaking about that issues right now. But sometimes it is better you understand yourself first. What are your shortcomings? What are your blocks? And try to develop that in such a way that where you become an optimistic person. Let us see some more things here. Here, why does self-compassion beat self-confidence? While self-confidence makes you feel better about your abilities, it can also lead you to vastly overestimate those abilities. Self-compassion, on the other hand, encourages you to acknowledge your flaws and limitations, allow you to handle yourself at the same time for a more objective, realistic point of view. See, dear friends, here what happens is that, let us understand you, I think we have discussed about self-confidence in my previous videos also. Like self-compassion, on the other hand, encourages you to acknowledge your flaws, maybe the difficulties, shortcomings, and your own negative thoughts and all, and allowing you to handle, understand yourself from a more objective and realistic point of view. Dear friends, I feel that it is very important. As you give importance to your self-confidence, similar way or same way, self-compassion should be given more importance. Why self-compassion is very important because see, you need to acknowledge your shortcomings. You need to acknowledge what are your difficulties. You need to acknowledge what are your limitations. At the same time, you need to see all the limitations, all the negativity, all the shortcomings in a realistic point of way, in a very objective way, so that you work on that. You demonstrate yourself on that, or you work on that in such a way that as the days goes on or as the year goes on, you try to overcome all the limitations, all the shortcomings, all the blocks, all the what I can say, desires which is really blocking you. You can everything, you can overcome it. But what happened if you, now the question is very simple here. If you don't have self-compassion, if you don't have a compassion, then where you are going to reach, where your mind, body and spirit is going to reach is a question mark. Because if you don't see the things in a realistic way, if you don't see the things in an objective way, or if you don't put effort, a minimal effort, to understand your own self, then there is no growth, then there is no personality development. So dear friends, I think by the time you might have understood why the person should have the concept of self-compassion and how this concept will help the person to develop. Yeah, the implication can be, if you are kind to yourself in the face of your own mistakes and flaws, you will be stronger and a more resilient person. Now you also know what is strong, and you also know what is resilient. Resilient is something where you can quickly come out from your difficult condition. Dear friends, now you might have got the idea why the self-compassion or the compassion is very important. Dear friends, we all have difficulties. We all have faced difficulties in our life. Sometimes we may not be able to understand why I am facing this and what is the reason behind these difficulties or blocks. Or maybe I want to ask you one question here. Do you really know the difficulties what you face? Or do you really know the negative what you face? And have you ever tried, or you have ever discussed the difficulties or negativities of your life? Or have you ever tried to come out from that? Sometimes what happened, many people whom I have seen, they live with that. And they continue with that, but they don't want to find a way to come out from that. So dear friend, that will not happen. If you really want to come out from these difficulties and all, these blocks and all, you need to really take help from other people whom you know, whom you trust. I think they will show you a way. They will help you to understand a way. Because dear friends, if you watch the series, in different series if you watch, and nowadays we feel that, where you can see different types of people act, react, or they demonstrate many things. So this is very clear, this is very clear that you need to love yourself first. You need to understand yourself first. And you need to see that whatever difficulties you have, whatever the shortcomings you have, you try to come out from that and see that you become stronger and resilient person. Because dear friend, every one of us in our life, we have to be strong in one or the other way, and we should be a resilient person. So dear friends, in a nutshell, here are my wishes for you. Dear friends, why these wishes? Because if you are seeing this video first, then you may not able to understand why I have added this slide here. If you see all my videos, the greatest psychological discoveries, all the four parts, you will understand the summary of this. See here, that you will take joy from the small things in your daily life. This is what I explained you first. Identifying the small things, analyzing the small things which happens in and around, and you really enjoy that you will be aware of what you're feeling in the moment. In my previous video, I have told you that in the moment what you're feeling, or the difficulties what you're feeling, and you will try to come out from that you will take care of yourself by getting enough sleep, because I told you, dear friends, 7 hours of sleep or 8 hours of sleep is very important and really necessary. that you will treat yourself with the same kindness and compassion that you offer others. Just now I discussed with this. Dear friend, these are my really wishes for you. I have seen that many people watch my videos and many people are sending me text messages. Many people are sending me that do videos on this topic, do videos on that topic. So this time I got this message, the four greatest psychological discoveries, and I thought I'll make a video for you. Dear friends, you have been watching my videos. And many of you have already subscribed to my channel, and many of you are sending me mails, many of you are sending me feedbacks, and many of you are sending me text messages and all. I think that is a great joy for me. And you are making me create or do more videos so that I can reach you in a better way. Dear friends, the intention of my YouTube channel is nothing but spreading mental health awareness, and you all know that. Many people in my previous videos also I told you very clearly, people always speak about physical health, many people don't speak about mental health. My intention is very clear, and my YouTube channel intention is very clear, that I want to spread mental health awareness in a very simple way so that everybody should understand. People also tell me that, so your English is very good, very good, in the sense you speak in a way that everybody can understand. This is the intention of this channel, so that everybody should come to know the basic concepts of psychology, everybody should come to know the basic concepts of mental health, and the main intention is that you should understand what are this mental health and mental illness. And the moment you come to know that these are the symptoms of this particular disorder, that will help you to deal yourself in a better way, deal your family members in a better way, deal your own friends and relatives in a better way, or deal your community in a better way. So dear friends, keep supporting me, and don't forget to give me your feedbacks, and in whichever way, if you want to send me a mail, my mail ID is there, you can send me a mail also, and in which topics you want videos, or which topics you want me to make videos, I'll be doing that, I'll be ready to do that for you, and keep supporting me. Thank you very much.